everyone, welcome to this new tutorial. This is the second part of our series about Luxcore Shader for Noobs. And this one we will cover especially glossy translucent and matte translucent material. So let's go. The first thing about glossy translucent is that when you start, you are by default the settings. So the shader is not does not transmit enough light. So to make it happen, you have to play with this color, diffuse color, and make it black, so you get light passing through the sphere, the material. And you need to make the transmission color very white, so this way you get most of the light passing through and scattering inside the material. So why is that? So basically the diffuse color is here to set how the mix between the normal glossy appearance and the transmission part is done. So if I do something like 0.5, what the engine is seeing is that I have 50% I have 50% transmission and 50% of diffuse glossy in the shader. If I do something like 0.1, then I get 10% of diffuse and 90% of transmission. So the darker you get, the more transmission, the more scattering effect you get in your glossy transmission material. The second thing is the color of your transmission event. So if you make it dark, you get a darker appearance, and if you make it white, you get more scattering effect inside the transmission. But this is not the end for this shader. You also have a setting called double-sided. This is very important because first one for shader like this that used for candle, you can make the shader appear more bright by clicking on this material. So the scattering effect will happen on the double side of your object. So let's click on it, and you can see that the sphere is very, very bright. So this is very important to notice. So this is the first thing you have to do. So what kind of thing you can do with this shader? So let me show you something. For those who want to make things like butter, so things like cheese or human skin effect, SS effect, you need to use this shader plus an homogeneous material. So the first thing, you do the settings so you get the scattering, and you add a volumetric effect inside of your shader. But as you can see, we start to get some kind of particle inside our shader ball. So the way I used to work to control the appearance is to make my principal shader to be completely transparent with opacity layer, so I can get all the information, all the thing happening when I set my homogeneous volume. So let's set this one and increase the value to something like 5. Okay, with 5 you get this foggy effect from the scattering, but as you can see it is white, so we can make it a bit like a skin color, something like this. And we can now play with the absorption color to make it more saturated, so a bit like something like 0.1, so you get this orange scattering effect. It is a bit dark, so we need to make it a bit brighter. So don't forget to use multi-scattering, so you get an even brighter shader. So this is it. And what Next, the next thing to do if you are going to make something like a skin is to make your opacity coming back, but you don't want the full opacity of your object. If you do like this, so as you can see, there is less light entering the sphere and bouncing inside and make it brighter. So what you need to do, if you want to make something like a kind of plastic and something very complex like candle, so you can go maybe with first settings. But if you want to make skin, then you need this opacity to be around something like 0.30 or 0.25. The setting that work best for me is 0.25. So this work great for me. And if you want the glossy appearance to be more strong, then you have to play with the specular color. Okay, so as the time we are using it, we have double-sided effect applied. So we have specular color for one side here and another specular setting here. So instead of checking and changing those settings separately, I use a constant color shader effect and node, and plug it here and here, so I get the same for both, completely black, no reflection. And as you go white, you can see we get some kind of reflection. We can even increase this part to something like 8, so we get more scattering inside, and we can reduce this one. So you can see we have roughness here and roughness here, so we can use something, another node to control the two parameter constant value, and put it here and here too. So you need something 103. Okay, very interesting. So we have something interesting. We can even increase this one to be like this, something like change the color of this one to make something like cheese. Okay. As you can see, we start to get a shader very much like butter and thing like skin. Also, you can play with those settings to get the kind of effect you want. Maybe you want to have a bit like something like blood inside, so you can go a bit completely red, reduce the particle inside your volume, something like 50, and you can reduce the opacity, something like this, or maybe increase it, and mix all the thing here with your texture, and add another texture here to make your skin. So maybe I can try it for you. Okay. As you can see, I have my skin shader on top of the material, so I can remove this one and full opacity on, reduce the specular effect, so you can see what is happening with the with the texture, and we need to make it a bit smaller. Okay, it's look a bit better, but the sun is very, very strong here. We also have this transmission. Okay, start to work quickly, and then we need to make okay. But the thing that is happening now is that okay, because we have the diffuse with a bright texture, so we get a completely diffuse appearance. So what we need is to reduce now the opacity to make the scattering appearance of the volume with the diffuse look of your shader. So the more, so we can make something like this. Okay, 0.4, very interesting, and maybe change the color to be less aggressive, a bit yellowish. Okay, then you can see we get something very interesting. You can maybe change the lighting. Okay, with this lighting you can see that the ball is looking very good, very well. This is very interesting. So you can play around the settings. You can play with the specular to make it more shiny, and play with it and get something that look that fit your needs. Okay, maybe I can add some bump. Oh, my color is changing again, so let me for an hour. Okay, oh, I'm still registering. Okay, it's nice. Okay, this is it for those who want to make skin. This is the setting you are going to play with. And maybe I want to add some kind of, maybe I can add a simple normal map texture. So let me try it. Let me select this one. It is a random texture, nothing with okay. And you can see okay, we can make it less big and less pronounced. Please. 0.3, so you start to get something a bit nicer. Okay, I hope that you are able to see how it's look and how you can maybe improve yourself the shader and make it look a bit like you want. You can mix many different textures. You can use the opacity layer to make some difference in the scattering happening on your object. And this is it. Okay. But the next thing we want to do, I hope you understand. So let me do it again. First thing, you have your material glossy translucent, glossy translucent, and by default you get a diffuse glossy appearance, okay, normal glossy appearance, normal shader. What you need to make more scattering look is to make the diffuse darker and make the transparency, the transmission brighter. The next thing you need to do is to add the double side effect on it to make it even brighter, so you have some scattering happening inside. The next thing is to add a volume, homogeneous volume. Don't forget to make multi-scattering, and then you need a color that fit your need. Maybe it is skin, maybe it is butter, maybe it's candle, maybe it is marble. And you need to increase the scattering scale. The more particle you have, the more opaque your shader will be. So 10 and get something very opaque. And at the time you have four settings, you need now to reduce the absorption depth so you get the color of your shader. And the next thing to do is to reduce the opacity. Okay, so you still get more light passing through the skin of your shader and going inside to scatter again. And the next thing you want to do is to add your texture. Okay, add the texture, image texture, maybe the skin, maybe it is something else. Okay, next thing you want to know, it is about another translucent material. It is matte translucent. It is the same thing, but with one difference: you don't have the glossy effect on it and you don't have double-sided. So same principle, you need one, the reflection color to be dark, and you need the transmission color to be brighter. So this one is used for thing like paper, it is used for cloth, it is also used curtains. It is also used for curtains, cloths, paper. They all use that. You can make it a bit less a bit more bright, so you have less scattering happening inside. So you can also add some kind of volumetric inside, homogeneous volume inside. So now let's together do something. We want to make a leaf material. I promised you in the first tutorial. So you need a glossy translucent material. Plug it here. We don't need a volume, material volume. We now need our texture, texture, image texture. Well, let me do something else. Import multiple textures. So for that, plus this one, and it is enough. Okay, I have both my normal map. I check normal map here and put it in the bump. Next, I need to be double-sided. Next, I need to have control over the roughness or the specularity. So let me add something for the specularity. It is constant color. Okay, one for this one and one for this specularity color. Increase. Okay, and then you need your color here, and then you need transparency. So you check this alpha map, because I have a PNG, and put it in the opacity. When it's done, you can see it is working, but there is still something to fix, because the transmission color is still white, you get this gray effect around it. So how to fix that? Normally I just put a view saturation value not here, so I can control the color of my leaf. So just put it here. You can make different view saturation color for both diffuse color and transmission, but for this tutorial I just use one controller. So let me make it a bit less saturated, or a bit less darker. Okay, so we make it brighter. Okay, less saturated, and we want it to be a bit yellowish. Okay, this is good. Okay, you can turn around and see how it look, and I think it look great. Okay, it look great. I hope you can see how great it is. It is very interesting. We can also change the lighting, so you can see, let me let it for render, and maybe you can see that I'm using CPU for rendering inside the viewport, and this is because from time to time, because I'm using the last version, the build of Luxcore 2.4, I can sometimes get some bug around the OpenCL version. So OpenCL can be very different from this one. So to make all the thing clear, I just step on the CPU rendering. So let's change the lighting and use HDR. So I remove my panel by hiding them and put normal HDRI. Okay, and you can see we have a nice color. Okay, but suppose that you want to make your leaf a bit more, to have something, some shadow, some more green shadow. So I have a small tip. This is for optimization. You can use the shadow color here and fix some kind of transparent green reflection, so you can make it a bit greener, so you start to get some green shadow here. So you can fake the shadow using Luxcore. Okay, you can, if you make it darker, so you get some more dark and opaque shadow, but if you make it brighter, so you can get something like this, and this can be very helpful for the engine, and also can boost your rendering realism by using some fake techniques. So I hope you enjoy it, and thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you want more tutorial. This is for all for this one, and let's see you the next time.